guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So if you guys are like me lately, I'm sitting around a lot, my back is starting to give me some trouble, so I've got a good sequence for you if that's also your case. So we'll need a long foam roller, and you can do this without the foam roller, but this obviously is going to give you a little bit of a myofascial release while we do the movement, so this will be to your benefit. All right, so we're gonna start laying long way on this, on our mat, and then we'll just start there. Okay, once you've gotten comfortable from your tail to the top of your head on the roller, just find where the center of your spine is, or as much of the center as you can get on there. It might feel a little crooked if you're really tight, and then I like to just sway a little bit side to side, just changing pressure for our feet. This is gonna be a really nice, stretchy, feel-good class today. And then we'll hold our roller, hold our body steady. Take your arms out to a T, palms face up towards the ceiling. On the inhale, we're gonna raise our arms together above our heart. And then as we exhale, we're gonna turn the palms away and push the air away from us. Inhale, the palms come together above the heart. And then exhale, push it away. Really reaching through those fingers, not really listening to what our body is wanting to do, right? Maybe those ribs are popping up, but we're trying to push them down, trying to let the back line of our body get heavy. Pulling the hands together, and then pushing the hands apart. We'll do one more of these, and then we'll start to switch this up a little bit. You're gonna let your right hand cross over, your left hand cross over, doesn't matter which one's in front. Start to take the arms down towards your hips, drawing a circle, and then bring it back up overhead. Stretching, letting the ribs lift this time, and then pulling them down as the arms come back down. Inhale as the arms reach, like the first stretch you take in the morning. And then exhale as you pull it back around. Maybe alternating what arm is coming in front of your face every other time there, exhaling them through center. We'll do one last time like this. Inhaling as you reach, exhaling as you stretch them around, and then let's switch direction. So arms open to a T, and then we start to bring them down to our hips, crossing one in front of the other. Continue past the nose, up and over. Inhale, get that stretch. And exhale, back to our sides. Crossing opposite in front. How close can you get to your nose? And then bring it around. All the while, just letting your backside melt into the surface of the roller. And then we'll go one more circle here. End with your arms by your sides. You're gonna take your palms down. Maybe the palms are lifted, the fingertips stay connected, and we're gonna start to close the space between our low back and the roller. So tucking the pelvis, you're gonna exhale, pull the low back down so that we're totally imprinted here, and then inhale, fill that space back up, release the squeeze in the glutes. Exhale, pull the backside down as you curl it up. Inhale to release and find that length. Notice how right hip feels versus the left hip. Or maybe just tune out here and enjoy this nice mellow class today. Exhale, curling and lifting. And then inhale to come back. We'll do this about four more times. Maybe noticing as you exhale, can you tuck a little bit deeper? Finding the low abdominals to influence the release of the low back. Here's last three. Shoulders are staying open around the roller, pushing down through the ribs just as much as your shoulder blades. And then on this next one, you're gonna hold the tuck. Stay with that imprint. I'm gonna take my heels a little bit closer to the roller, and we're gonna start to hover the hips. So just lifting up maybe a slip of paper underneath the booty, and then bring it back down. Inhale, bring space back to the small of your back. Exhale, tuck the pelvis, find that scoop, hover the booty, and then release it back down. Inhale at the bottom, exhale, we tuck to find that scoop, pulling from the front and then back down. It should feel like you're squeezing the roller between your shoulder blades, really drawing the shoulders down to lift the hips up. Now we're gonna hold this bridge. Take a notice of what's going on with your feet here. Can you connect evenly inside edge, outside edge? And then from there, let's take our arms up, inhale, and then we're gonna start to go back to those circles. They're gonna go overhead and then wrap them around towards the sides of you. Inhale back overhead. Now, depending on how dense your foam roller is, this might get intense for you if your shoulders are really super tight. I think this feels nice, but feel free to take it down a level if it doesn't feel nice for your body. And then let's reverse our circles, come back down, open out and around, and then back in front of you. Stretching through the fingertips just as much as we're stretching through the shoulders. And then last circle here. And then come back to your sides the same way we got there, roll back down to the foam roller. From here, we're gonna start to take this into our knee floats. Your right leg's gonna start, heel lifts, big toe is last, float that leg to tabletop. And then bring it back down, big toe, ball of the foot, heel is last. Inhale, left heel, ball of the foot, big toe follows, lift it up there. Now, as you do this, I want you to try to minimize the amount of movement in the roller. All right, you might feel it start to waver just a little bit. Can you hold the back line of your body so heavy that nothing moves? All right, it's the ultimate test of control here. And now you might be like, hey, I think I'm working a little harder than what I signed up for. It's sneaky. Adds up there. Lifting the right side, pushing through the floor with your left foot, and then back down. It's almost like an oppositional. Push through the right, lift through the left, whoo, and then come back down. One more time, right side is gonna come up and stay there. From here, let's take this right side, inhales like you're gonna stand on the ceiling, flex that foot, and then lower and bring it back into a tabletop. Inhale, stretch it up, flex it up, and then bring it back in. You should feel the back line of your hamstring getting a little bit of a stretch. Maybe the calf also with that flexion at the top. Lift it up, flex it up, and then come back down. We're gonna lift up, flex up one last time. Stay there, we're gonna flex, lower the leg, and then point the toes and lift back up. Notice, are your hips changing as you do this? Inhale to lower. Exhale to lift. We're gonna do this twice more. Inhale, lower. Exhale, lift. Last one, lower. You're gonna start to take it back to the top, and we're gonna hold it at the top, bend the knee, take your left leg up to meet the right, little test of balance, and then the right side comes down, and we flex and lift the left. Bend and point the toe. Flex and lift. Pulling back on the toes, finding that lift through your ankle, through your heel. And then last two. Flex up, stretch up. And then one last time we'll come up and we'll stay. Notice if that left hip is hiking, stay there, flex it, lower the leg, inhale. Point the toes, reach like you're painting a stripe on the ceiling to come back up. Inhale, flex it, lower it. Exhale, point the toes, lift it back up, paint that stripe. Inhale, flex lower. Exhale, point the toes, lift it up there. I love doing a series on the roller because it not only gives you that stability challenge, but it makes you kind of focus in a little bit more on where you're stabilizing from and get those correct muscles to work. And you get that negative space down at the bottom, a little negative space to reach into and lift. We're gonna hold it at the top of this last one. We'll bend the knee and we'll take it to tabletop. From here, you're gonna take that right leg up to meet the left. Try to keep those ribs heavy so we don't get tension in our low back. Now from here, we're gonna keep our legs sandwiched together. Start to take the feet up to the ceiling. Same thing we did before, but now with both legs. Flex them like you're standing on the ceiling. Bend those knees back in. So this to me feels like Cadillac footwork. One of my things I've been missing lately is using the Pilates equipment that I don't own at home. So I'm trying to get creative with ways to still do those movements that I love without having access to the equipment that I need for them. So I hope you all are doing the same things. And maybe I can help. Last two, lift it up, flex it up, and then push it away, curl those toes. One more, we're gonna stay here. Flex those feet. Now from here, the legs are gonna scissor. We're gonna drop the right one away, pull the left one in, feel that stretch. And then inhale, exhale, they switch. Keeping the feet flexed is gonna give you more hamstring. And since stretching is our focus, we'll try to keep it that way. Inhale, exhale, switch. It just makes it so much harder. Inhale, exhale, switch. We'll do this twice more. We'll take it to bicycle. And then let's hold the split. Curl the right heel in as the left leg lowers. And then we extend the right leg up. Find that split, stay for a breath. Curl the left side in as the right side lowers. Extend the left leg overhead, find that split. Curl the right side in, extend through your left. Reach the right one overhead, we'll do that one more time. The slowest, but probably the most you've ever gotten out of your bicycles. Hold it here, take it into your helicopter. We're gonna circle the legs out to the side and then continue, left low, right high. Hold it there, we're gonna circle them back. Right side goes out to the right, left side comes up on the left, and we pause in our split. Inhale, exhale, wrap them around. Whew. Nice opening for those inner thighs, but again, the belly's gotta work for it. One last time. And then let's bend those knees in together. Take the feet down one at a time. And just tee your arms out. Notice the difference of your spine here. Maybe walk your feet a little wider. And just take your head side to side. Maybe our shoulders have already opened up a little bit more. My favorite way to get off the roller, you're gonna pick a side, roll yourself off. Notice the difference with your back. I always love this because it's like the floor is hugging you. It's a little bit concave now. So we're gonna take our roller behind our knees. Oh, let me get back to my mat. And then move your roller underneath your booty. Kind of picking up where we left off here. Just find where that sacral spine wants to lay over so our hips are parallel to the floor. And already that might be a stretch for those deep psoas muscles. I like to hold the sides of the roller, but you can bring your palms on top as well, just wherever it makes sense for you. Take right leg, left leg up to tabletop. And then from here, we're gonna keep our legs sandwiched together. You're gonna start to roll to your right hip, let your left hip lift. And just notice that stretch. I already got a nice little crack in there. And then come back through center, inhale to get there. Exhale, bring the legs over to the left side. Massaging into that IT band, and then inhale to bring it back. Now the shoulders might want to lift with this, or maybe at least just one shoulder. See if you can lean back into that shoulder. It's like you're stretching in opposition, leaning away from your legs, maybe looking over the opposite shoulder, and then inhale to bring them back to center. Let's try that one last time to our right. Looking over the left shoulder, and then back through center. One last time to your left. Look over the right, and then come back through center. Now adding on to this, we're gonna add the legs splitting as we drop them to one side. So you're gonna drop the knees over to the right, extend your left leg forward, your right leg back, and you should feel like you're right on top of that IT band. Now it's a little intense, breathe. And then bring the legs back together and come back through center, same as before. We take the legs over to the left side, the right foot reaches forward, the left foot reaches back, and then we come back together with our legs, bring it back to center. So this really should offer a nice bit of broadening across the hips, across your pelvis. really stretching out everything that gets tight when we're more sedentary. Over to the left side, the left leg extends forward, right leg extends back. I might have just switched that, I don't know, it just felt right. Try that again, we're on the other side, left leg extends back, right leg extends forward. Yeah, that's definitely different, but hey, whatever, it feels good. This is just about what feels good today. Let's go back to right leg over, left leg back. Just notice the difference. Come back together. And then last one here, left leg reaches, right leg reaches back. And then we'll come back together, back to center. Maybe readjust where our hips are if we moved there. Okay, so noticing hips over the roller might be a little bit more open, especially towards the sides of our hips. Now from here, we're gonna start to take this into some leg circles. So our legs are gonna come up, we're gonna turn out, so heels together, toes apart, Pilates V. We're gonna open the legs and then start to draw a circle down towards 45, squeeze those inner thighs together, and then bring it up the middle. All the while trying not to let the hips tuck or tilt. You can bring hands to the top of them to make sure we're not moving, and then bring it up with the belly. So we're using the belly muscles, not the tucking movement of the pelvis, to move the legs. Here's last two. Inhaling the legs around, squeezing back up the middle, and then last one, open inhale, exhale back up to the top. Reverse your circles, inhale them down, exhale out and around. Really getting that external wrapping, top of the thigh, around into the booty. And last two. One last time, inhale, reach, exhale, back up and around. All right, now from here, we're gonna take this into a little bit of a prep for rollover. And if this doesn't feel comfortable for your spine, you're not gonna lift your hips off the surface of the roller. So modified version first, you're gonna push your hips down, try to keep the reach as you bring the legs over, exhaling breath from the belly to close the gap between your thighs. Flex your feet, open the legs about shoulder width, and then we come back down, push through the heels, find that reach, and close them together, point the toes. So the only thing I'm not doing here is lifting. I'm pulling the belly in, pulling the belly in, use that exhale, flex open, roll back down. Okay, full rollover. If this feels good, stick with this. Push down into the surface of your roller, lift the booty up, flex open, roll the hips back down. Keep pushing through those triceps to find that little bit of an anchoring. Squeeze those inner thighs together, lift, roll it up and over, flex open, roll your hips back down. We'll do that one more time, then we're gonna reverse directions. Roll it over, press through those triceps, keep the shoulders from your ears. Open, flex, roll down. Now we're gonna do the opposite. They come together, tap, open, flex, starting with the legs open, roll it over. Close them, point the toes, roll yourself back down. Try to land in the same spot that you lifted from. Open, flex, roll it over. Close them, point the toes, roll yourself back down. Open, flex, roll over. Close them, point, roll back down. And then just one more like that. Flex open, roll it over. Close them, point them, roll it down. Whew. And then let's take those knees in. Just for fun, let's take the knees side to side again. Notice if it's a little bit more comfortable for you to roll into that IT band. Right, might feel a little bit more natural. We'll go back to our split. Left leg reaches over as we go to the right. And then back to center, inhale. Reach the right one over as we go to the left. And then come back in. We'll go one more time side to side. Just noticing now that we're a little bit more open across our hips. And then last one to the left. And then bring it together. Lift the hips and roll the roller away from you. We're gonna bring our feet on top and keep them about a fist distance apart. So we're still hip width here. Notice how your back feels. Where do you feel pressure? Maybe close the eyes just to tune in a little bit more. We're gonna keep our roller pulled in as much as possible, and we'll try to keep the inside edges of our feet connected just as much as the outside edges. So arms by our side, take a nice big inhale. As you exhale, go back to that pelvic tuck that we started with long way on our roller and lift up to your shoulder blades, holding the roller in. There's that challenge. And then exhale, roll it back down. Inhale at the bottom, untuck the pelvis. Exhale, we roll it up. There's no room for those hamstrings to take a break here. Inhale, exhale, roll back down through the center of your spine. And then exhale, tuck the pelvis, find that lift across the shoulders. We're gonna hold the next one lifted, so not this one, come back down. Inhale, take a break. Exhale, roll up, stay lifted. Check in with those feet. Do you feel inside edges of your feet lifting? Push them back down. Oh, that's different. Okay, inhale, we're gonna push the roller away. Exhale, pull the roller in. And you don't have to go all the way. We're doing four of these. Inhale it out. Exhale to pull it in. Here's last two, dig deep. Inhale out. Exhale, pull it in. One more, getting some adjustments in the knees. Exhale, pull it in. Inhale, roll it down. And then let's take our roller away, reach our arms overhead, and just get a little stretch here. Maybe alternate the feet and get out of those calves and hamstrings. So from here, we're gonna take this into our 100, but we'll do a little prep first. Make sure that the roller is underneath your heels, not so much your ankles, just because the tendons don't like this as much. So find the heels, make it comfortable. Keeping the heels on the roller resting, we're gonna take the hip flexors out of 100 today. So arms are gonna reach up above you. Take a nice big inhale. And then as you exhale, you're gonna curl up and over your belly button. Ribs, curl yourself up. Push down through those feet. See if you can curl a little bit higher. We start to pump those arms. Inhale, four, five. Exhale, two, three, four, five. Inhale, exhale. All about that breath here. It's exhale, two, three, four, five. Inhale. Exhale, two, three, four, five. Inhale, two, three, four, five. Exhale. Last three. Exhale, three, four, five. Inhale. Exhale, two, three, four, five. Last one, curl up a little bit higher. Push through those heels. Exhale, two, three, four, five. Lower, rest. Take the arms overhead, get that stretch. And then let's take our right knee, give it a hug in here. Leaving your left leg out where it is. We're just gonna hold it here and just give ourselves a little stretch. And then let's take our left, or our right leg, and cross it over to the left. Or maybe just look over to our right hand. Just a nice little low back twist. And then we'll inhale to come back through center. This leg is gonna stay here. You're gonna bring your right ankle in front of your left knee and pull the roller in with your left foot on top of it. So now from here, we're gonna think like footwork. This is one of my favorite reformer footwork variations to stretch our piriformis muscle. So you're gonna inhale the foam roller away from you. And then as you exhale, you'll be increasing the stretch. So we pull the belly away, contracting the core as we find that pull in for our stretch. And then inhale, bring the space back. Dig deep, pull into the belly as we inhale. And then exhale, pour that breath out as the knees come in. And this should feel good. Inhaling out, exhaling back home. Here's last two, reaching it away. Exhale, pulling it back in. And then on this last one, we'll hold the stretch in. And we're we're gonna rock it side to side a little bit. So leaving the left arch on top of the foam roller, you're gonna start to drop both knees over to your left. The right foot will come on top of the floor. And then we'll start to bring it back through center. Drop both knees over to your right. Looking over your left shoulder in opposition. Inhale back through center. Exhale, drop over to the opposite side. Inhale back through center. Exhale, drop it over. And then just last one here, holding in the center. You're gonna take your right foot down. Roll the roller away, hug your left knee in. Just hang out there, maybe rock a little side to side. Notice the difference, one leg to the other. Granted, we just stretched the other one, so maybe this one already feels a little different. And then we're gonna take this leg and cross it over to our right, just gently guiding it there, maybe looking across to our left. And then we'll bring ourselves back to center, leaving our left ankle in front of our right knee. Pull that foam roller in for your piriformis figure four stretch. And then we inhale the roller away, letting that stretch release. Exhale, pull the roller in. Trying to get every little spot across the back of your heel, back of your ankle. So we don't skip any places. Pulling the carriage. I wish. Can you tell I miss a reformer? Exhale, pulling it in. My brain is still on autopilot. Reaching it away. And then let's pull it in, hold it in there. From here we stay. We're gonna take it over to the right first. Left foot comes to the floor. We look over the left shoulder. And then inhale, come back through center. Exhale, drop them both to the left. Countering the stretch with a little inner thigh release. And then back through center. Bring it over to the right, looking to the left, and then back through center. One last time, side to side. And then we finish in the center. We take that left foot back on the roller. We're gonna bring ourselves all the way up here. I want you to bring your arms overhead. As you roll the roller away, you're gonna roll up, finding like a roll up or a teaser kind of movement today. So inhale, exhale, you're gonna push the roller away, roll yourself up, push through those heels, lift at the top, get tall, and then exhale, let's roll back down. So just kind of putting everything together here, that hamstring curl, roll up, teaser. Inhale, exhale, curl, rounding up, scooping through the belly, pushing through the feet, lifting at the top, and then exhale back down, rounding out the spine, pulling the belly away, trying to get one rib down after the next. Inhale, overhead stretch, pull those feet in, and then one last time, let's come up and we'll stay there. Lifting to the top, pushing through the heels. And then from here, we'll take our hands around behind us. We're gonna pull our roller in, drop our knees to the right, pull the knees into center, and then drop them to the left. And then I like to add a little pulling in as I drop one way and then the other. It just feels good. And then last one. I'll do a little bit of prone work before we cool down for good. Okay, so let's take ourselves around to our bellies now. You're gonna take your hands or your wrists across the top of the foam roller. I always go to my wrist because then I have more room to pull in. You'll find pretty quickly where you wanna go depending on your range of motion. And then legs a little bit wider just to keep the pelvis nice and broad. Palms face each other, neutral shoulder position. We're gonna leave our forehead down on the mat, and if you don't quite reach, you can bring a yoga block here just to bring the floor up to meet you. We're gonna start by retracting the shoulder blades, just pulling them down the back. Just notice how far you can go before those elbows feel like they have to bend. And then inhale as you reach them back up to your ears. Exhale, pull the shoulder blades down your back. And then inhale it back out. Notice if one shoulder feels like it has more
range of motion available to it than the other, maybe indicating some imbalance we need to work on. Exhale to pull in. Inhale, reach back out. Now as you feel more comfortable, feel like you're picking up your belly, picking up your chest, and hovering the chest. Not lifting the chest, just hovering, and then come back down. So I'm not changing the position of my neck. I'm just lifting from my belly and letting the head follow. Looking at the same spot on my mat the whole way up and the whole way back down. Inhale, get cozy at the bottom. Exhale, start to pull the shoulder blades down the back, push through those armpits and come up. And then we release back down. Let's just do three more times here. Exhale, pulling the roller in, maybe changing your range of motion if you feel like you're getting more flexible as you do this more. And then one last time here, rounding, pulling those shoulder blades down your back, rolling it in, lifting the ribs. Take an inhale, stay for a breath, and then can we just pulse? Coming forward a few inches, lifting up a few inches. Lifting from your belly, not your back. Think front side, lifting like there's a fire underneath you. Here's last two. And last one. And then we'll come all the way back down. And we'll start to take ourselves back into a child's pose. So hands are gonna come underneath your armpits. You're gonna push your hips over your heels and take your foam roller with you, and we'll use that for some negative space. It's an option, you don't have to use it if it doesn't feel good. So hands or arms come over the top of the roller. Forehead again comes to your mat. And my knees are a little bit wider than my ankles, so feel free to take that route as well. You're gonna take your right arm, reach up to the ceiling, look at it as you inhale. And then as you exhale, we're gonna reach that right arm underneath the left and twist out towards it. So just closing the eyes here, taking a moment to let the shoulders separate from one another. Breathing into the space between them. Maybe rolling out that left wrist over the roller, taking advantage of the myofascial release. All sorts of crunchiness in there. And then let's take our right arm back out. Take the right arm over the roller. Take a little stretch in the middle. And then we'll start to take that left arm up as we inhale, look up towards it. And then exhale, thread it underneath the right side. Looking towards the right, breathing into the space between your shoulders. Maybe again, rolling out that right wrist. Ooh, this one's very crunchy. I guess I shouldn't be that surprised. There's always one side that's just a little bit crunchier than the other. And then let's bring that left arm back. We'll take one last little child's pose here. And then let's start to add a little bit of an extension to this. As you inhale, you're gonna shine your heart forward and lift up. And then as you exhale, you're gonna roll the roller away. And then we're gonna go one time into a rounded back. So this next one, you're gonna round and look to the floor or look to your belly button. And then inhale, press back out. This time exhale, lift the chest. It's extension, and then we go into flexion. Inhaling out, exhaling in. Inhaling out, exhaling, lift the heart. Shine it out there. Let's do this twice more. It feels really nice. Exhale, round. Pull that belly button up to your spine. Inhale it back out. And then exhale, lift the heart. Shine it out there. Last one, we inhale it out. Exhale, round. Continue all the way up into a kneeling position. And then we're gonna take this into mermaid to finish today. So right shin in front of you, left to the side. I'm gonna have my right hand on the foam roller and it's gonna end up coming to my forearm and my palm will turn forward. So feel free to move the wrist around as it feels right.
press the roller away, reach overhead with your left, hold it there. We're gonna rotate under, exhale, reach underneath your right arm, inhale back overhead, and then exhale all the way in. We're gonna take a counter stretch here. So I'm gonna do this the same way that I teach Reformer Mermaid. So nice familiarity. Reaching over, inhale up and over, exhale, reach it under, inhale, wrap it overhead, come back in, and we counter the stretch. And then just one more time here, roll it away with the right, reach through the left, try to ground that left sits bone down through the floor, rotate under, inhale back overhead, and come in all the way. Counter the stretch, and then little challenge here between sides, fix my hair. Take your roller into your hands. Without using your hands, can you transition your legs? So find a little ball, balance, and then take the legs over to the other side and take the roller down on the left of you. Okay, readjusting those sits bones, find where that right one was gonna stay closer to the floor. You're gonna push the roller away with your left arm, reach over with your right hand, and then we add that rotation. Exhale to come under, inhale back over, exhale all the way home, and we counter it. Inhale up and over, lifting through your heart. Exhale, reaching with that right, pushing the left away. Exhale, wrap the ribs under. Inhale, stack them back overhead, and then come back in. Counter the stretch, we'll do that one last time. Inhale, back through center, reaching up and over. Exhale, rotate, back overhead, and all the way in. And then one last counter stretch. All right, and then from here, let's just take ourselves into a comfortable seat. Doesn't matter what leg is in front of the other, we'll take our roller in front of us, and we'll just take this into a little stretch here to end today. You're gonna push the roller away, round your spine. Just let your heart drop down towards your heels, and then inhale to lift back up. Just a nice little final stretch. Inhaling down the middle, exhaling back up, and then just one more time, inhale it away. Exhale, come back up, stacking, rounding all the way to the top. Continue the arms up with you as you inhale, and then exhale, let go. You guys are all done. Awesome job today. Thank you so much for joining me. I hope this eases some of the tension in the low backs we've all been dealing with from being a little bit more sedentary than we're used to. So enjoy, come back to this one, and thanks for watching. Bye.